Previously on Fairy Godfather the sitcom.
Well, if I'm gonna be fucking hallucinating you, I'm gonna need at least to make the most of it. So because of this, I believe we should get along, just for the hell of it. Sure, you're a hallucination. Sure, I'm nothing more than a schizophrenic 14-year-old. But maybe, just maybe, this could work. I feel like this could work.
That's a great idea. I'm glad you agree. Now let's get to the root of your depression by traveling back in time to where it all began.
Oh my god, we're going into the second dimension. What the f- Oh, my head hurts.
And now, where our heroes left off.
Oh, where am I? It's all dark. Hey, does anybody have a light? I see something. Oh, that's better. Hey, who are you?
You don't know who I am? You've got some fucking nerve walking into this town in this dimension again after what you've done, Martinez. Now listen here, buddy. If you don't get me those smeckles... Yes, it's a Rick and Morty reference, but I don't give a shit. By 8 p.m., sharp, this dimension's time, I will blow your fucking head off with this 9mm blaster. And you will not have any friends like that gay little hallucination of yours. And yes, we can see them over to clean it up. Do you understand me? Do I make myself perfectly clear when I speak? Now get the fuck out of here, you disgust me. Human white trash.
Wow. What a dick. The question is, what do I do now? I don't know anything about where I am, what year it is, or anything about dimensions or nothing. I'm basically a lost sheep. Fairy Godfather, do you have any advice about this? And how could this man see you? None of this is making any sense, and we need exposition fast to avoid people getting confused. So please do something. Anything. I need this to make sense.
Well, from what I understand, the time machine malfunctioned, and now we're traveling through dimensions. But they're not dimensions you would think of, like in Rick and Morty. They're your subconscious. We're technically inside of your brain right now. And we're facing every single fear or insecurity about you one by one, whether that's physically or mentally, until we can get to the bottom of what your depression is to either cure it or just make it a little less bad on you. I'm sorry if I can't exactly give all the answers, but this wasn't my time machine. I'm very sorry.
Hey, I don't want to face my fears. What do I look like, Jack Nicholson? Okay, that was just an obscure celebrity reference to get the Hollywood nerds on my side. But in all reality, I really have no plan to face my fears. If anything, I am accustomed to this world already. Considering this is all in my brain, I know that there is a shopkeeper. Now, this may not make sense to anybody, but I have a plan. Now, you see, if this is my brain, my thought patterns can control what goes in and out of it. So, by default, there should be certain sections that I can go to. Now, I think the best option for right now would have to be to go to a shopkeeper, and I know I can imagine one into existence, right? Right? Well, let's give it a try anyway. Okay, I have to use my left hand, for obvious reasons. Hello, other Xavier, or Traveler, as I am legally obligated to call you, because to avoid time paradoxes as well as dimension warpings. May I interest you in my many wares of guns and hats? I have many guns and hats, as you can see from our selection. Now, I may not be rotating properly. See, we have hats and guns and one gun, actually. Now, I'm willing to give you all anything you want. Just name it. But we have a currency here that you'll need to be accustomed to. Of course, there always has to be some shitty video game mechanic because I perceive everything as a video game. Damn it, I knew my subconscious would get the better of my conscious mind. Alright, what kind of stupid fucking currency do you use here anyway? Oh no, traveler, there's no need for that language in these parts. After all, we are a peaceful village of other clones of your subconscious thought. But I am here to remind you, we do have a currency. We call them tickets. You see, I have a couple on me, and I'm willing to spare at least three for you to purchase a gun that can be used to see that other person, Xavier, that had extreme hatred towards you. What did you do to piss that guy off? He seemed like he was really angry. I don't know. I just showed up here one day, and then he said he wanted me dead in the 80s and that I owed him money. I don't know what to do. And tickets, that's not Schmeckles. Wait a minute, is he just a retarded Rick and Morty fan that somehow found a gun? Am I anywhere in the right vicinity of what is going on? Well, I'm not entirely sure. However, I can have you challenge him to a duel. I have my money on you, considering you're the main character of this. I mean, to avoid time paradoxes, you're a very strong-looking individual. I have my money on you. Now, how about this? I'll give you 6 tickets, which is 3 extra, for the gun. Actually, how about I make a deal? I'm a negotiating man, you see. I will give you the gun for free. If you win, you get 3 tickets, and I make 0 profit. How does that make any sense whatsoever? I'm not questioning the fact that I'm getting a free gun and free money, but I'm also questioning your business ethics, considering... Ah, screw it. Give me the gun, and can I get a hat, too? Because I don't need a hat. Thanks, I'll take this gun. This gun is incredibly hard to handle. No wonder you're giving it to me for free. I mean, the handle alone is so long and misshapen. It's terrible what they do to these things. Alright, I'm gonna try this out now. Thank you for everything. No problem, bud. It's on the house. But next time, you're gonna have to pay some serious tickets. Just kidding. One ticket is for each hat. And if I have a new gun, that's 3 tickets. And you can sell various objects you find around your mind in order to sell back for tickets that you earned or sold. Now, go out there and make me some 0 profit margin. I'll see you around, bud, because I'm literally the only clone here besides many others. Alright, thanks, man. You've been a help, and you're a fucking gentleman and a scholar. I'm taking this gun, and let me test this out real quick. Alright, this is just an orange toy gun. Wait, let me see if this works. Wow. That was somewhat satisfying. Okay, enough with the crazy eyes. I got an asshole to kill. Good luck, buddy. And remember, my 0 profit margin is dependent on your very existence, let alone the fate of the universe. So have a good one. Bye-bye. Hey, hold up. What did you say about the fate of the universe? And it's probably not important. I got stuff to do.
To the town of Alfrio rode a stranger one fine day. Hardly spoke to folks around him, didn't have too much to say. No one dared to ask his business, no one dared to make a slip. The stranger there among them had a big iron on his hip.